Hey everybody, happy new year. It's if you're watching this, you made it through hands down the craziest year that I've ever experienced in my 46 years now on the planet. But it looks like to the start of 2021, we are not getting much less crazy anytime soon. So wanted to share with you a couple of things. A lot of people make resolutions each new year and try and start the year off right. And we're now through a week and change of the new year. And a lot of times those resolutions already have faded. So wanted to share with you a couple of things that I'm going to be doing and working on and trying to make myself better, make my body better. And wanted to share them with you. And if you wanted to check them out, feel free. The first is a 10-day focusing on you challenge. My friend, Dr. Lisa Olszewski, is a chiropractor out in Michigan, and she put this together. And I haven't gone through it yet, but it's a 10-day different topics and varieties of things to try and work on your self-care. And self-care is really, as she mentions, it's not being selfish, but it's critical to take care of yourself, especially during these times and trying to control what you can. So that's definitely something I'm looking forward to, and I'm going to get that started on Monday. So I wanted to share that with you, and there's a link below for that. Another thing I'm going to start on Monday is also a fasting challenge. And I've been experimenting with intermittent fasting, and you know, a lot of people don't get scared that you're never going to eat again. You're going to starve to death. And this is something that might not be for everybody by any means. And just something that I'm doing and wanted to share if you'd like to try. But it's through Ben Greenfield, who's a prominent personal trainer and kind of self experimenter and biohacker, and does some really cool things, and wrote a book called Boundless, which I really enjoyed reading during quarantine. Has a lot of tips and things in there and strategies for self-care. And the challenge is there's different degrees of fasting. You have someone like Gandhi, who did months at a time and long, prolonged fasts. But then there's different degrees in what's in intermittent fasting. And something I've been doing is typically not having breakfast or lunch, but then just having one meal a day at dinner. And this isn't by all means do all end all solution, but something that I'm going to be doing and dialing in a little bit more and extending my fast. So my plan is to do a water only fast on Monday and Tuesday, and then go into a bone broth fast for Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So there's going to be a link to this 5-day challenge below. It's just something that if you want to read more, learn more about it, there's some great information and resources here. And if it's something you want to try even for a day and just see how your body feels and responds. But there's a lot of information out there on helping to decrease inflammation, which is certainly a huge challenge in a lot of different conditions and comorbidities. And so things like intermittent fasting can help your body decrease inflammatory response, can also help to boost growth hormone, can help to help your immune system get a rest, and then let your body fight things off even better. So this is something that can be very practical and relevant, and try and help you take the best care of yourself that you can, again, during these challenging times. So if it's something you want to check out, feel free. If you want to pass it along, awesome. If it's something you think is not for you, that's totally cool too. But we're going to be sharing some more topics and things to come here, and hope that you can make the best out of this new year, and stay well. Have a great day.